Hi, I'm Dave Holzer with Wisconsin Metal Parts. Welcome back to our introduction to progressive stamping dies. Today we're going to be talking about design and design considerations that go into a progressive stamping. So when we get a part print from a customer, one of the first things that we're going to do is look at, can this part be made? And better yet, can it be made in a progressive die? Is that the most cost-effective way to do it? There are other means for making parts out there, but is this the best way to make your part? We're going to look at the tolerances on your part print. Can the part be made in a progressive die to your tolerances? And we also are going to look at the materials that the part is being made out of. That is going to drive us to determine how robust and also impact the tooling costs of the die as we are in the quoting stage. Life expectancy is another big thing on how robust a tool needs to be. And finally, if you have any internal die design standards, that is going to impact what we need to put into your tool because you'll be dictating that end of it. Another factor that goes into a quote for a die design is if there's any challenging areas that we might want to prototype before we get into building hard tooling for it. So that's something else that we would look at to see how we want to handle. After the quoting stage, we would get in a customer purchase order, and at that point we do a contract review where we're verifying what the rev levels are, we're making sure that we have the right drawings, and our first thing that our designer is strip layout concept, and that's going to be shared back with the customer for approval. And after we get past that area, we're going to do a full layout of the die, where the majority of the die is going to be designed at this point. And the customer is also going to be involved with an approval on that die design. After that stage, it would come back, and our designer then would go through and they would break all the components of the die out into individual pieces, and that would be on our die design, which would in turn go out to the tool room for the tool makers to build. So that may or may not trigger another review with the customer. It depends on what the customer wants to do. But at that stage, we would definitely be doing an internal design review where we would have the design team together along with the tool makers, and they would have a chance to go and review the die and the components, make sure everything is what they want to be able to do to build and that they're in agreement that it's going to be able to make the part. And from that strip, we start to build the die block components and also the punch components. And then from there, we start building the holders that are going to hold those components. And then finally the die sets and the die shoes and any other things that the customer needs based on their design criteria. We've got other add-on softwares that we use with our design software, Fastform, which is a software that helps us determine if there's any areas of concern that might be candidates for tearing or ripping or thinning when we're doing forming. We also have DR Blank, which helps us when we're doing round draw parts, helps us determine how many draw stations we're going to need in order to get enough material in there. And we also use Logo Press. And Logo Press is a nice add-on that helps us in the design process of making our designs come through a lot quicker. So with that, all this stuff is designed to help reduce development costs and ultimately the final cost of the tooling as well. So after a tool is built, we're going to come back with any information from our tool makers and back to our designer, and then we're going to update our design. That's important because if there's any changes that happen while out on the shop floor, we need to make sure that we've got an updated, accurate design. So if there's any repairs down the road or if there's any updates, changes that need to happen, we've got what we need in the design phase. So here at Wisconsin Metal Parts, we design, we build, we run progressive stamping dies. We also do gauges and fixtures. If you'd like more information about us, please give us a call or check out our website at www.wisconsinmetalparts and send us over your drawing. We can take a look at your part with you and we can come up with the most cost-effective solution to meet your needs.